The StageMix app for iPad has revolutionized the workflow for sound engineers mixing at live events around the world. Now at the end of 2017, we are celebrating the 500,000th download, and we've just released StageMix version 7 for Yamaha CL and QL consoles. Let me show you some of the best features. The first one I know is going to please many users because we received so many suggestions about it. It is custom layers. Take a look in the center of the meter bridge for the custom selector. Touch it and see 10 meter bridge blocks as usual. But now each block can be customized by touch and hold. For each block, select whether you want to see a standard input channel layer, DCA or output layer, or any custom fader layer that is available on the console you are controlling. Scroll through the meter blocks by using these nudge buttons at the top. Now, we are not assigning channels to the console's custom layers here. That can only be done on the console. We are selecting which of the console's layers we want to view on StageMix. It'll make navigating through large numbers of channels quicker and more intuitive. You could see the most important inputs, groups, and outputs all together on the same layer. Additionally, each fader bank can be named on the iPad with up to 8 characters. Double tap, enter a name, such as drums, or choir, or wireless, for example. These names appear on the meter bridge, making it easier for the user to find the necessary channels quickly. By the way, this selection is memorized in the iPad along with the console's IP address. So each time you connect to a familiar console, the setting will return. And if two iPads are used to control the same console, they can each have different custom layer assignments to suit each operator. When you have the custom layer selected in StageMix and you go to a channel edit screen, such as EQ or Dynamics, now when you scroll through the channels, you follow the assignments in the custom layer rather than the fixed channel layers as before. Another thoughtful and convenient addition to the app. Another great feature of StageMix version 7 for CL and QL consoles is that of consecutive patch editing. Remember, with the previous version, input patch editing was added, so in the gain window, you could double tap to edit. Well, now if you touch and hold an input port selection, a new pop-up will appear. Here, you can edit how many consecutive channels you want to patch. So for example, it now takes just one operation to patch 16 ports from slot 1 to channels 1 to 16. Before we finish, 3 more new tips. If you're using Shure wireless mic systems without Dante, such as the Axient AXT400 or QLXD, you can flip between the device's receiver gain and the console's analog gain. So here in the gain window, you get these new RX, TX buttons. Then perhaps you just want to rest the iPad on the console and use it as an additional meter bridge or RTA display. In that case, in the setup menu, the new disable auto lock screen option will be useful to keep StageMix visible all the time it is open. Finally, to avoid any Wi-Fi interference during a busy show, you can use a cable connection between the iPad and the console. Use the camera connection kit with a power supply, then a USB Ethernet adapter and a Cat5 network cable, which can be up to 100 meters long. Thanks for watching and enjoy the mobile mixing and monitoring which StageMix provides so well.